and a good morning, good afternoon, and a very good evening to you, the good and wonderful people of the Chupapotepin Grand, and those in your world. I have this guitar to show you today, people of the Tube. Look at it. Look how gorgeous this thing is. Oh my god. Yes, this is a real Gibson Les Paul custom in Alpine White, I do believe it. It has gone a bit yellowy. This is a Gibson custom shop model, custom model, should I say, from 2010, I do believe. And this belongs to my good friend Mike. Again, Mike, you're a legend for letting me borrow these guitars and bring them to all these people of Tube. Thank you very much indeed. And this is an insanely good guitar. Swallowing your own spit, on the other hand, is not insanely good. That is just horrible. Anyway, end of this week, people with Tube, we will be doing a shootout between this guitar and my Tokai custom, because I have to do that. It has to be a thing. But yeah, today is just about this guitar. Like I say, this is a Gibson custom from 2010, a custom shop. It's just exactly what a custom needs to be, especially, you know, these are just disgustingly amazing. I would say that white customs are nearly one of my favourite Les Pauls next to a gold top. Gold top pits it to the post, definitely, for me. But white customs, there's something about it. You know, having grown up listening to kind of like Manic Street Preachers and the Sex Pistols, you know, the white custom has a very, very special place in my heart. It really does. And I say, it was James Dean Bradfield, really, who was the first guy that got me into kind of wanting one of these things. And then the first college I went to, a guy had an Epiphone version of his guitar, and I was just like, what is that? That is so cool. And I've never really lost my love for it. So when I got my Tokai, I was very, very happy. And I love my Tokai to bits. And again, like I said in the guitar collection video, back guitar, the Tokai will never leave me. Like I said, at the end of the week, though, we will be doing a shootout between this and that. Anyway, yeah, mahogany body, ebony fretboard. Gibson humbuckers in there. I don't really know what else to say. This thing rules the day. It's extremely heavy. This is actually a little bit heavier than my Tokai. My Tokai is 10.5 pounds, and this one is a little bit heavier. So it's only a little bit though. It's not a great deal, but it's just a little bit over 10.5, this guitar. It's so heavy, after a while it just breaks you. Hence why I'm sat down now and catching my breath after the intro jam. Anyway, this thing's really awesome. You've got the medallion on the... I don't know how you perceive that. You've got the medallion on the selector switch cover there. I say you've got the Gibson custom thing on the headstock there. Got a Grover machine heads. This thing is just insanely good. This is just one of those just like wow guitars. When you pick it up, it just goes wow. It really does. It's so cool. The only thing that I wish my Tokai had is an ebony fretboard, because the ebony fretboards on these customs, how black they are and how shiny, there's just something about that that makes it really, really cool. But I'm not going to lose sleep over it. Anyway, people of Tube, I think that's enough wiffle waffle. It does and says and is what it says on the tin, this thing. I love the headstock as well. I actually prefer the Tokai logo to the split diamond on my Tokai custom to the actual split diamond of a Gibson. But that is just iconic, isn't it? You know, that is an iconic headstock right there. Anyway, people, without further ado, let me show you some of the sounds this thing has in it. We'll just go through it clean, and then I'll shove on some pedals as well, and just let you hear this guitar in isolation before we do the outro jam at the end, and just get lost with this thing for probably about 5 minutes before my shoulder collapses under the weight. But again, massive thanks to Mike. I have another Mike guitar coming soon, which again is an amazing guitar. That man's got some incredible guitars. But now, let's get into... My God, look how solid that thing is. There's just nothing. There's just no kind of like hollow bits on this guitar. It's just like... Bleh. Anyway, let's get into showing the tones of this thing in isolation. ¶¶ Okidoki Pikachu, there you go. That's the sound examples in isolation of the 2010 Gibson Les Paul custom shop. This thing just sounds so smooth. Like, everything, he just sounds so clear. There's no harsh edges on any of the sounds or anything. It's so rounded. It's unreal. It's absolutely unreal. For those sound examples, I was mainly using the Marshall Governor 2 Plus. That was kind of the main heavy sound you heard. The clean tone was just my Marshall MG. I'm using the Marshall MG today. I fancy a change from the Orange for a while, so we're back to the Marshall MG for now. And the kind of like the semi-broken up sound is just the Golden Plexi. This thing is just ridiculous. So it basically plays itself as well. The setup is fantastic. The neck is amazing. It feels a little bit wider to my Tokai, which I'm kind of not surprised by. I can imagine the Tokai is a little bit skinnier, E to E, just to kind of like, you know, not just to kind of get out of that kind of thing of not being an exact copy. But it's absolutely awesome, this guitar does. It really is. And I say a massive thanks to Mike. You know, I'm so grateful for him to be lending me these guitars of his. This is an absolute monster. It really is. Beast. Absolute beast of a guitar. Anyway, Pikachu, what we're going to do now is basically just a big outro jam. I'm just going to play this thing, see what comes out of it. I really want to go soundscapey. So we're going to go soundscapey because that's where I am now. I've kind of got the heaviness out of me, if I will. With the intro jam and some of the stuff I just did then, I was kind of like, now I kind of want to mellow down a bit. So we're going to do something a bit more kind of... I'm going to try and channel Robert Fripp, a fellow custom user, although his is black. His was black, should I say. He doesn't really use them anymore. His Fernandez Les Pauls are gold tops. He does have other ones though, doesn't he? He has some of those Crimson Guitars ones as well. But he started out on a custom, black custom. So let's try and do some Robert Frippy, soundscapey, Frippatronics. It's not going to happen, but I'm going to try kind of thing and see where we go. But this thing is amazing. Again, I just... To be able to play one of these things like this is insane. I've really enjoyed playing this guitar. It's really, 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 really cool. Again, Mike, you're a legend. But yeah, this guitar is insanely good. It really is. Absolute monster, but extremely nice monster. It's like one of those monsters that kind of helps you. You know, it's one of those monsters that wants to rip your face off and grind your bones to make bread. It's one of those monsters that kind of wants to help you make bread, but in a nicer way. You never had a mind, Dave. Anyway, Pikachu, I hope you enjoyed this vid. If you like the vids I do here, please consider becoming a patron on Patreon. Link to that is in the description box below. As well as links to my merch store at Teespring and also links to my Bandcamp where you can go and listen and please consider buying some of my music on there. There's quite a lot on there, so there's a lot to be kind of like listening to and seeing what you like. And like I say, any support is like welcome. I say Patreon people, though, I couldn't do it without you at this point in time. You are literally my lifeline to this what I do. It's like without you, this isn't a possibility. So thank you so much indeed. I really can't thank you enough. I really can't. So anyway, without further ado, Pikachu, let's make some more noise with the 2010 Gibson Les Paul Custom Shop Les Paul in the most gorgeous color. I mean, there's something about white, black and gold on these guitars that are just a ridiculously iconic. You know, they really are. Randy Rhodes, Steve Jones, James Dean Bradfield, you know, Justin Hawkins, you know, so many people use these things and they're just an iconic guitar. They really are. Like I said, Robert Fripp didn't use a white one, he had a black one, but you know, he's a custom guy. John Frusciante, big custom guy. Not anymore because he's giving it to Dave Navarro now, but back in the day he had his Black Beauty. You know, so many people use these things. Anyway, that's enough whiffle waffle. Let's make some music and let's get lost in this thing and see where it takes us. So thank you very much indeed for watching, PeopleTube. I'll see you again on Wednesday for an A&Q. Until then, have a great morning, afternoon, good evening and goodbye now. Thank you much indeed for watching. I need to find a key now. F sharp minor. I think that's a good one.